Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. You are about to see a story of murder, greed, corruption, violence, adultery, and treachery. All these things we hold near and dear to our hearts. Thank you.
Five, six, seven, eight.
And all that jazz.
Oh, she's on a ship.
opera?
Yeah, I'm afraid so, Roxy.
Oh, Fred!
Yeah?
Nobody walked out on me!
Sweetheart!
Oh, don't you sweetheart me, you son of a gun!
Cheerful little murderer.
Murderer? Why, just last week the jury thanked the man for shooting the burglar.
Well, that's just fine. Sign right here, Mr. Hart.
Freely, gladly.
And now, as Roxy Hart, in a song of love and devotion to her dear husband, Amos.
Sometimes I'm right, sometimes I'm wrong, but he doesn't care. He'll string along. He loves me so, that funny, honey, young man. Sometimes I'm down, sometimes I'm up, but he follows around like some droopy eyed pup. He loves me so, that funny.
Oh, no!
pretty cold-blooded murder, Miss Hart. A lot of the hanging for that one.
Hang me?
Not so tough now, are you?
Oh, Amos, did you hear what he said? Hang me! Oh, God! Jesus, Mary, and Joseph, have Christ!
And now, the six Mary murderesses of Hill County Jail in their edition of Cell Block Tango.
Pop! Six. Squish. Cicero. Lipschitz. Pop! Six. Squish. Cicero. Lipschitz.
They had it coming.
He'd go out every night looking for himself, and along the way, he found Ruth, Gladys, Rosemary, and Irving. I guess you could say we broke up because of artistic differences. He saw himself as alive, and I saw him dead.
Mama. the Princeton crew. When you're stroking mama, mama's stroking you. So, what's the one conclusion I can bring this number to? When you're good to mama.
Oh, Amos, I knew you'd come to see me. I've been sinful, I know, but I want to make it up to you. And I can, too, as soon as I get out of here. See, there's this lawyer, and he costs about $5,000.
Roxy, I'm tired of fancy footwork. The answer is no.
Look, I know I lied to you, and I know I cheated on you, and I've even stolen money from your pants pockets while you were sleeping.
You did?
But I never stopped loving you. Not my Amos. So manly, so attractive, and oh, so marriage, so sexy.
But Roxy, it's 5,000 bucks.
My hour of need, for Christ's sake.
Well, all right. I'll get it for you. I'll get it for you, Roxy.
And now, presenting the silver-tongued prince of the courtroom,
the one, the only, Mr. Billy Flynn.
Turn. Did you hear Mr. Billy Flynn's voice again?
Really?
Yeah, I heard he's got a new chick this time.
You know, I always wanted to be a lawyer.
Okay,
extra,
buddy.
Extra! Extra papers! Come and get your case!
Come on! Mr. Billy Flynn wins again! Just hand us the papers.
Okay.
Oh, thank you.
Oh. Billy? I'll get another one. Anyway, Mr. Billy Flynn strikes again. He's got a new girl. Roxy Hall.
Roxy.
Anyway, he's on a press conference with her right about 2 minutes.
2 minutes?
There you go.
You're going the wrong way, buddy!
Hello, Andy.
Amos. My name is Amos.
Right, did you bring the rest of the $5,000?
Well, here's $500 on my insurance, and $300 I borrowed down at the garage from the guys, and here's $700 from the building and loan fund.
That's $2,000.
And that's all I got so far.
What about her father?
Well, I phoned him yesterday, and he said he could probably make up some of the money later.
Is that really what he said? You know, you're a damn liar. I spoke to her father myself. You know what he said? He said that his daughter went to hell 10 years ago, and she could stay there forever before he spent a cent to get her out.
I'll give you $20 a week on my salary, Mr. Flynn. Notes with interest double, no, triple, until every cent is paid off.
You know, Hart, that's touching, but I've got a motto, and that motto is play square, dead square. Now, when you came to me yesterday, I didn't ask you if she was guilty, I didn't ask you if she was drunk, I didn't ask you if she was innocent, I didn't ask you if she was dopey, no fool's questions like that. Now, did I? No. All I said was, have you got $5,000? And you said yes, but you don't have $5,000, so I figure you're a dirty liar.
I'm sorry, Mr. Flynn.
But I took your case, and I'll keep it because I play square. Now, the first thing we'll do is I'll get her face on every front page as the hottest little jazz star since Selma Kelly. Then, we announce we're holding an auction. They'll buy anything she's ever touched. Shoes, dresses, underwear. And we announce that if I due process of law, she gets hanged.
Hanged?
The stuff triples in value. I'll give you 20% of everything we make, over $5,000, and that's what I call playing square.
I don't know, Mr. Flynn.
You see, it's like this. Either I get the rest of my $5,000, or you'll rot in jail before I bring you your trial.
Oh, Mr. Flynn, I'm not very good at this kind of thing, but don't you think we can make some sort of arrangement?
Hey, you mean one thing to me, and that's $5,000. Now, in a few minutes, we're going to hold a big press conference here. There'll be a whole bunch of photographers and reporters, and that Zal sister from the Evening Star is coming. Her name is Mary Sunshine.
Mary Sunshine's gonna interview me? Oh, crap!
Hey, pipe down on the swearing. From here on in, you say nothing rougher than oh dear. Get it? Take that out. Now. So, first thing you gotta do is go over to sympathy of the press. They're not all pushovers like that, Mary Sunshine. But there is one thing they can never resist, and that's a reformed sinner. So I've decided to rewrite your entire life story, from convent to jail. Get this. Beautiful southern home, every luxury and refinement. Parents dead, educated at the Sacred Heart. Young runaway marriage, full of life. Lonely innocent, you were drawn by the mad world of the great city. Jazz, cabarets, liquor. You were drawn like a moth to the flame. Sit down. A butterfly, crushed on the wheel. You have sinned and you are sorry.
Beautiful.
Hey, cut out God too. Stay where you're better acquainted. Now, when they ask you why you shot him, all you can remember is a fearful quarrel, and he threatened to kill you. You can still see him coming towards you with that awful look in his eyes. And get this, you both reached for the gun. That's your grounds, self-defense.
Mr. Flynn, the reporters are here.
Let him in. Good day, ladies and gentlemen. Miss Sunshine, you know my client, Miss Roxy Hart.
Ladies and gentlemen of the press, I'm just flattered you came out to see little old me. Now I bet you want to know why I shot the bastard.
Sit down, dummy.
Mr. Billy Flynn sings the press conference rag.
Notice how mouth never moves. Almost.
Mississippi.
And your parents.
Very wealthy.
Where are they now?
6 feet under, but she was granted one more star. Coming out of the Sacred Heart. 1920.
How old were you?
Don't remember.
Then what happened?
I met Amos, and he stole my heart away. Convinced me to elope one day.
Oh, it's too terrible, you poor, poor dear!
My ex-boyfriend.
Was I just to him?
I was leaving.
Was he angry?
Like a madman. So I said, friend, move along. She knew that she was doing wrong. He came toward me.
With a pistol.
From my bureau. Like a tiger, he had strength and she had none, and yet we both reach for the gun. Oh yes, oh yes, oh yes, we both, oh yes, we both, oh yes, we both reach for the gun, the gun, the gun, the gun, oh yes, we both reach for the gun. Understandable, understandable, yes, it's perfectly understandable. Comprehensible, comprehensible, not a bit reprehensible, it's so defensive.
How you feeling?
Very frightened.
Are you sorry?
Are you kidding?
Hey.
What's your statement?
All I say is, though my choo-choo jumped the truck, I give my life to bring him back. Stay away from jazz and liquor. The part that came upon me when we both reached for the gun.
Understandable, understandable.
Yes, it's perfectly understandable, comprehensible, comprehensible. Not a bit reprehensible. It's so defensible.
Saved it. Now look.
Rock.
Roxy Rock Chicago.
Thanks, kid.
Now I'm going to tell you the truth. Not that the truth really matters, but I'm going to tell you anyway. I always wanted to be a dancer in vaudeville, have my own act.
But no. No, 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 no. One big world full of no life.
And then I met Amos, who never says no.
You know, some guys are like mirrors.
When I look into Amos's face, I'm always a kid. You could love a guy like that. Now, not to get too crude, but in the bedroom department, Amos was a
zero.
So I started fooling around. And then I started screwing around, which is fooling around just
without dinner.
I gave up the vaudeville idea because I figured opportunity just passed me by.
Oh, but it ain't. Oh, no, 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 it ain't.
If this link guy gets me off, I could still have my own act. And I could still be a dancer in vaudeville. Now I've got me a world full of yes!
Sparkly dress.
The name on everybody's lips is gonna be Roxy. The lady ranking in the chips is gonna be Roxy. I'm gonna be a celebrity that needs somebody everyone knows. They're gonna recognize my eyes, my hair, my teeth, my legs, my nose. From just some dumb mechanic's wife, I'm gonna be Roxy. Who says that murder's not enough? And to link in case she doesn't hang, you say she started with a bang. Roxy Hart. I'm gonna have me a swell act too. I'll get me a boy to work. Someone who can lift me up and show me off. Oh hell, I'll get two boys. It'll frame me better. No, 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 no. Think big. Think big, Roxy. I'm gonna get me a whole bunch of boys. Oh, darling, you lost your little hat. Don't worry about it. The name on everybody's lips is gonna be Roxy. The lady ranking in the chips is gonna be Roxy. I'm gonna be a celebrity, somebody everyone knows. They're gonna recognize my eyes, my hair, my teeth, my legs, my nose. From just some dumb mechanic's wife, I'm gonna be Roxy. Who says that murder's not enough? And to in case she doesn't hang, can say she started with a bang. Roxy, Roxy Hart. Of those autographs outside, good luck to ya, Roxy. And I'll appear in a lavalier that goes all the way down to my waist. But always in the best of days. Ooh, I'm a star. And I love them for loving me, and they love me for loving them, and we just love each other. And that's because none of us got enough love in our childhood.
And that's showbiz, kid.
Giving up her come from life.
I'm gonna be
Roxy.
Really nifty.
Watch this. Bench.
Will you stop biting me? I'm gonna hydrophobia. this way, ladies and gentlemen. My client will answer all your questions, and after, I'll be happy to give you the interview myself. Hi, Trixie.
Trixie? So,
I said Roxy.
Oh, Mr. Flynn.
Boy, what the hell, you know? And socially, too. Her mother owns all the pineapples in Hawaii.
Pineapples? What the hell do I care about pineapples? Look, you have my trial date.
Look, kid, I'll get to it.
Something I'd like to discuss about my trial, too.
Oh, hi, Mama. Oh, Miss Sunshine. Can I call you Mary? Boy, this girl from Old Pineapple Money is a gripping story, really.
Oh, pineapples. Oh, I got a feeling you're in trouble, Roxy.
Socialite? You lose again, Velma.
There's only one person who can help you now, Roxy.
There's only one person you can count on now, Velma.
And now, Miss Roxy Hart and Miss Velma Kelly sing a song of unrelenting determination and unmitigated ego.
Can you imagine?
Can you believe it? I mean, can you believe it? I know a girl who lands on top. She could put her face into a pail of slop, and she'd come up smelling like a rose. How she does it, heaven knows.
Oh, look, there she is now.
Well, is she or isn't she?
She is. I know a girl with so much luck. She could get run over by a two-ton truck, then brush herself off and walk away. How she does it, couldn't say.
Doc, would you swear by that statement in court?
Yes, sir.
Great. Wipe that lipstick off your face.
Whilst I, on the other hand, put my face in a pail of slop, and I would smell like a pail of slop. And I, on the other hand, get run over by a truck, and I'd be deader than a duck. I know a girl who tells so many lies. Anything that's true would nearly cross her eyes. But what that mouse is selling, the whole world buys. And no one smells a rat!
Oh, ladies and gentlemen of the press, please leave the two of us alone to rest.
The two of us. Can you imagine? I mean, can you imagine?
Sure.
Anything for the press.
Can you believe it? I mean, can you believe it?
My dear little baby.
My dear little baby.
My sweet little baby.
Little.
Look at my baby and me.
Me and my baby and me. We're about as happy as babies can be. What if I find that I've got in a storm? I don't care, my baby's there, and baby's bound to keep me warm. We're sticking together, and ain't we got fun? So much together, you count us as one. Tell old man worry to go climb a tree, cause I've got my baby, my sweet little baby. Look at my baby and me.
I just don't see how you could possibly delay the trial another second, Mr. Flynn. My readers wouldn't stand for it, the poor child, to have her baby born in a jail.
I can assure you my client will be at the trial at the earliest possible moment, and you can quote me on that.
Hey, everybody, I'm the father! I'm the father!
Me and my baby and me. Dream of a duo, now don't you agree? Why keep it mum when there's nothing to hide? And what I feel I must reveal is more than I can keep inside. Let me assure you, it won't go away. I can assure you, it grows every day. I was a one once, but now I'm a we. Cause I've got my baby, my sweet little baby. Look at my baby and me.
Well, I think it's sweet. First time we ever had one of our girls in a family way.
I've got it, and it's brilliant. I'm gonna get Amos to divorce her. That way, all the sympathy will go to her, not him. She'll be the poor, deserted mother to be, and that crumb will be running out on her.
That's my kid! That's my kid!
Look at my baby and me. Facing the world optimistically. Nothing can stop us, so nobody try. Cause baby's rough and full of stuff, and incidentally, so am I. Out of our way, folks, and give us some room. Watch how we bubble and blossom and bloom. Life was a prison, but we got the key. Cause I've got my baby, my sweet little baby. My cute little baby, my sweet little baby. My fat little baby, my soft little baby. My big little baby, my bald little baby. Look at my baby.
no father. Papa! Dada! Did you hear me? Did you? No, you didn't hear me. That's the story of my life. Nobody ever listens to me. Have you noticed that? Am I making it up? Nobody ever knows I'm around. Not even my parents notice me. One day, I went to school, and when I came home, they'd moved. If someone stood up in a crowd, raised his voice up way out loud, and waved his arms, shook his leg, you'd notice him. If someone in the movie show yelled, "Fire in the second room, this whole place is a powder keg!" you'd notice him. And even without clucking like a hen, everyone gets noticed now and then. Unless, of course, that person it should be invisible, inconsequential, me. Cellophane, Mr. Cellophane, should have been my name, Mr. Cellophane, 'cause you can look right through me, walk right by me, and never know I'm there. I tell ya, cellophane, Mr. Cellophane, should have been my name, Mr. Cellophane, 'cause you can look right through me, walk right by me, and never know I'm there.
Right, you said it wasn't. No, it's the kid thing I'm thinking about.
What kid?
Roxy's kid. You know when she's due? Early fall? September? That means you couldn't possibly be the father. But I want you to forget, pass out those cigars anyways. I don't want you to give a damn when people laugh.
Laugh? Why would they laugh?
Because they can count and you can't count. Early fall?
Wait a minute, that don't figure out right. I couldn't be the father.
Divorce her, is that what you said? My God, man, you wouldn't divorce her over the whole thing like that, now would you?
That's exactly what I'll do. I'll divorce her.
Yeah.
She probably wouldn't even notice.
Oh, and you're still there. I thought you'd gone.
Yeah, I'm still here, I think. Suppose you was a little cat residing in a person's flat who fed you fish and scratched your ears. You notice him. Suppose you was a woman wed, sleeping in a double bed beside one man for 7 years. You notice him. A human being's made of more than air. With all that bulk, you're bound to see him there. Unless, of course, that human next to you is unimpressive, undistinguished. You know who. Should have been my name, Mr. Cellophane, 'cause you can look right through me, walk right by me, and never know I'm there. I tell ya, cellophane, Mr. Cellophane, should have been my name, Mr. Cellophane, 'cause you can look right through me, walk right by me, and never know I'm there, never even know. I hope I didn't take up too much of your time.
Ladies, get Roxy for me, will ya?
Billy! Billy, 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 Billy! Boy, am I glad to see you! Look, March 5th is only a few weeks away and I've been making plans. Look, silver shoes with rhinestone buckles!
Look, kid, I've had to delay your trial.
Oh no.
Less than a month, I had to.
And who got my date as if I didn't know, Miss Roxy Hart?
Look, there's a lot of pressure on me. She's having a baby, for Christ's sakes.
Yeah, yeah, tell me about it. Listen, Flynn, I figure if I'm sensational in court, I could get things moving again. I've been thinking a lot about my trial. Couldn't I just show you what I might do on the witness stand?
Go ahead.
Good. Hit it! Well, when I got on the stand, I thought I'd take a peek at the jury. Then I crossed my legs like this, you know. Then when Harrison cross-examines me, I thought I'd give him this. And if he yells at me, I thought I'd tremble like this. Ooh, no, please don't.
Velma takes a stand. Look at little Belle. See her. Give him hell. Ain't she doing grand? She's got an apple on her head.
Then I thought I'd all let it be too much for me, like real dramatic. Oh, oh. Then I thought I'd get thirsty, and I'd say, please, someone, could I have a glass of water? I thought I'd cry. Buckets! Only I don't have a handkerchief, and that's when I have to ask you for yours. I really like that part, don't you? Then I try to walk. Oh, but I'm too weak. So I slump, and I slump, and I slump, and I slump, until finally I faint.
I'll talk to you later, Velma.
Okay. All right. I guess I'll go. But not quietly. May I have my exit music, please? Thank you.
There you are. I've been waiting for 10 minutes. Oh, don't do that again. Look, I've got Amos to file for divorce.
Yeah, now what?
So now I can get him on the stand and admit that he made a terrible mistake because he still loves you, and of course, you still love him, and the jury will be swooning all over themselves to play Cupid and get you two back together. Smart, huh?
Smart, huh?
And another thing.
And another thing.
When Amos is on the stand, I want you to be knitting a baby garment.
I don't know how to knit.
Then learn.
Look, I am sick of everything.
everybody treating me like I'm just some dumb common criminal.
But you are some dumb common criminal.
It's better than being a greasy lawyer who's out for all he can steal.
Oh, I suppose you could appear in court without me too, huh?
I'm sure I could. You read the papers, Lady Palsy? They love me.
They'd love you a lot more if you were dead. You know why? Because you would sell more papers.
Well, you're fired!
I quit!
Any lawyer in this town would pay to have my case!
You're a phony celebrity kid. In a few days, they won't even know your name. That's Chicago.
And you know what? I want my $5,000 back, too!
No! No, no, no! Oh! No! No, no, no!
No! Oh, that girl. You stay. Stay. I'm sorry, Erin. She still says no.
Jesus Christ. Don't she know she'll be convicted?
No! No! Uncle Sam! Хороші, он знає, що я не нова. Он би мені положив в тюрму.
She says that Uncle Sam is just and fair, and that he wouldn't put her in jail because she's innocent. Erin, I think she's telling the truth.
What the hell has innocence got to do with it? Look, Mrs. Morin, this is a court-appointed thing. I don't get anything from this. Nothing.
What do you want from me? I've done my best.
Not guilty!
Foreigners.
Почему меня Uncle Sam не любит?
She wants to know if Uncle Sam will like her.
I don't give a damn what she wants to know unless she says guilty. Guilty!
Not guilty!
He's ready for you.
Well, here we go.
No.
Ladies and gentlemen, for your pleasure and your entertainment, we give you Miss Catalina Hunyak and her famous Hungarian rope trick.
Not guilty! Not guilty! Not guilty, Uncle Sam! Not guilty! No! Not guilty!
After 47 years, a Cook County president has been broken. Catalin Hunyak, famous for the brutal ex-murder of her ex-husband, was hanged today. The Russian woman's final words were, "Not guilty!"
So we're clear on what you're going to do in the stand, right?
I've been up all night rehearsing.
All right, then let's get to my summation. First, I'll say, if sorrow could avail, Fred Casey would be here today, for she would give her life and gladly to bring the dead man back. Then you nod.
That's all?
That's all for you. Then I say, but we can't do that, gentlemen. We may give my client a second chance, but we cannot bring the dead man back. That's always news to them. That's it for you.
But it's me they want to see, not you.
It's my speech that brings them in, and it's my speech that'll save your neck.
You damn crook!
Stop, you dirty little...
His honor's here.
Thank you, just a moment. Thanks. All right, you ready?
Oh, Billy, I'm scared.
You got nothing to worry about, kid. It's all a circus, three-ring circus, these trials, the whole world. All show business. Kid, you're working with a star. The biggest. Give them the old razzle dazzle, razzle dazzle them. Give them an act with lots of flash in it, and the reaction will be passionate. Give them the old hocus pocus, beat and feather on. How can they see with sequins in their eyes? What if your hinges all are rusting? What if, in fact, you're just disgusting? Razzle dazzle hum, and they'll never catch wise. Give them the old razzle dazzle, razzle dazzle. Give them a show that's so splendiferous, row after row will grow vociferous. Give them the old flim flam flummet, fool and thrasher up. How can they hear the truth above the roar? Throw them a bacon duffinagle, they'll never know you're just a bagel. Razzle dazzle them, and they'll beg you for more. Ladies and gentlemen, we present Justice.
The State of Illinois versus Roxy Hart for the murder of Fred Casely. Thank you.
The state calls.
Mr. Amos Hart.
Selby guy?
I certainly do.
Questioned by Sergeant Fogarty, what happened next? Answered by Roxy Hart, I shot him because he was walking out on me, the louse. Do you recognize this signature?
I certainly do, ma'am. It's the signature of the woman that used to be my wife.
Exactly. Take the witness.
Hello. Amos?
Amos, that's right, Mr. Flint, Amos!
Amos, you are at present obtaining a divorce of the defendant. Any reason?
I'll say. The newspaper said she's expecting a little stranger.
Well, that's hardly grounds for divorce now, is it?
A little too much of a stranger.
Oh, by that you mean you doubted the paternity of the child.
Well, sure.
Do you call that playing square, Mr. Hart? If Roxy Hart swore that you're the father of her child, which she does.
She does?
She does. Step down, Pops. The defense calls Roxy Hart.
Blah, blah, blah. Blah, blah, blah. Truth, truth, truth. Selfie God?
I do.
What's your name?
Roxy.
Roxy, I have here a statement in which you admit having illicit relationships with the deceased friend Casey. Is the statement true or false?
I'm afraid it's true.
You're an honest girl, Roxy. When did you first meet Mr. Casey?
When he sold me and Amos our furniture. Also, he was a regular patron at the nightclub where I was a member of the chorus.
And your personal relationship with him, when did that begin?
When I permitted him to drive me home one night.
Hey there, Chicky.
Hello, Mr. Casey.
Fine afternoon, ain't it?
Well, now, drive you home. It's raining so hard, no?
We seem like such a fine gentleman.
Yet, you were married, Miss Hart.
Yes, I know. And I don't think I would have gone with him if me and Mr. Hart hadn't quarreled that very morning.
Quarreled? Quarreled about what?
Oh, Amos, I don't want to work in that cheap Southside nightclub anymore.
Yeah.
And I don't want you working those long hours at the garage either.
Sure.
Oh, Amos, I want a real home and a child.
Fat chance. So you drifted into this illicit relationship because you were unhappy at home.
Most unhappy.
I love you, honey. I love you. Yet you do respect the sacredness of a marriage vow.
Oh, yes, sir.
Then why didn't you stop this affair with Casey?
I tried to, but he'd plead and he'd say,
I can't live without you! I can't live without you!
I was being torn apart!
Roxy Hart, the state has accused you of the murder of Fred Casey. Are you guilty or not guilty?
Not guilty, not guilty! Oh, I killed him, yes, but I'm not a criminal.
They're there. Roxy Hart, can you recall the night of February 14th?
Yes, sir.
Tell the jury, in your own way, the happenings of that night.
Well, it was around 2 a.m. and I had just got done work. And I stopped in an all-night grocery store to pick up some baking powder to make cupcakes for Amos.
Oh, Amos loved my cupcakes.
And I had just gotten home. I was getting ready for bed. And I heard the doorbell ring. Now, I thought it was my girlfriend, Gloria, so I slipped on my kimono and I went to the door.
And who was there?
Fred Casely.
And what did he say?
That note you wrote me, telling me it's all over? Why'd you write it?
Because I've seen the errors of my ways, and...
And?
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 And when you asked him to, did he leave?
I object! The counsel is leading the witness.
Sustained.
I'll rephrase the question. What did you say, Roxy?
I said go away!
Be it, buddy!
But he forced his way in. I ran into the bedroom, but he followed me.
Look, just have one little drink with me and then I'll go away, okay?
Why didn't you scream?
I was afraid to wake the neighbors. No good in come of this. Besides, I love my husband.
So you told him you loved your husband. What did he say to that?
It doesn't matter. You're mine.
Oh, I can't go on.
No, Roxy, you must go on. The jury has a right to know. You have to tell them everything.
Okay. Me and Amos are gonna have a baby.
And what did he say to that?
I'll kill you before I see you have another man's child!
And what happened next, Roxy?
In his passion, he tore off my kimono and threw me to the ground. Mr. Hart's revolver was lying there between us. He grabbed for it, but I knocked it from his hand and he whirled me aside.
And then?
And then we both reached for the gun, but I got it first.
Hooray!
He came at me with that funny look in his eyes.
I mean to kill
you! Did you think he meant to kill you?
Oh, yes.
So it was his life or yours?
Not just mine. So I closed my eyes and I shot.
Roxy, please.
In defense of your life.
To save my husband's unborn child.
Truly extraordinary!
I'm sure it has.
Seated next to her attorney, Mr. Billy Flynn, she weeps, but she fishes inside her handbag and cannot seem to find a handkerchief.
Handkerchief?
Oh, her attorney, Mr. Flynn, hands her one.
That's my bitch!
No, I wanna hear.
The poor child is at no relief. She looks around, bewildered, seeming to want something. Oh, it's a glass of water. The bailiff hands her one.
A glass of water? That's mine too!
Mrs. Hart, her usual gracious self, thanks the bailiff, and he smiles at her. She looks simply radiant in her stylish red dress and her elegant silver shoes.
With rhinestone buckles.
With rhinestone buckles.
Ah! Velma, take it easy.
But those were my shoes, and she stole them!
Well, you shouldn't have left them lying around.
First she steals my publicity, then she steals my lawyer, then she steals my courtroom date, and now she steals more shoes.
Well, what do you expect? She's a lowbrow. The whole world's gone lowbrow. Things just ain't the way they used to be.
Yeah, sure ain't, Mama. It's all gone.
Ladies and gentlemen, the final day of the trial of Miss Roxy Hart has come. A hush has fallen over the courtroom as Mr. Flynn prepares his summation to the jury. The next voice you will hear is that of Mr. Billy Flynn. Champion of the downtrodden.
Ladies and gentlemen, you and I have never killed. We can never know the guilt, the agony my client went through that day. The drunken beast, Fred Casely, forced his way into her home, forced liquor upon her, physically abused her. And in that moment, motherly love for my client's neighbor stirred within her. She shot him. We don't deny that. But there's one thing, she may take her life, but it will not bring the dead man back. But there's one thing we can give her, and that's a second chance. You've heard my colleague call her adulteress, call her temptress, call her murderess. And this is what the defense says. Things aren't always as they seem they are. The defense rests.
Fine, let's try this. Order in the court! Juror one, will you please approach the bench?
Has the jury reached a conclusive verdict?
We have, Your Honor.
Thank you. May the defendant please rise. What is the jury's verdict?
We've reached the verdict that the defendant, Ms. Ross,
you should see what's going on out there. There's this divorce action, and this babe shot her husband and her mother and her divorce attorney, and oh, there's blood all over the walls. It's terrible, but oh, it makes for a truly fabulous story.
What just happened?
You were found not guilty. That's what happened.
Where's the press? The publicity, I was counting on that.
You know, your gratitude, it's overwhelming, but forget I was only there for the money anyways.
Yeah, you get your $5,000 and what do I get?
You're a free woman, Roxy. God save Illinois, my exit music, please.
I don't understand that. They didn't even want my picture.
My exit music, please. Figures.
Like this has been performed. You've heard about them in the papers, and here they are for you now. Chicago's own killer dealers, those scintillating sinners, Roxy Hart and Velma Kelly!
You can even marry
Okay, you lovers of jazz, let's pick up the pace. Let's shake the blues away, make the parties longer, the skirts shorter and shorter. Let's make the music harder and all go to hell in a fast car and keep it hot.
Lost faith in America.